I'm delighted to be here at the Downtown Art Gallery today to discuss a little bit about my photography and from whence it comes, from where it derives. It's always great to share art with other people. The truth is, I got started in photography when I was about 13 years old. My dad was a professional photographer, and I used to go into his office or the studio all the time. And by the time I was 16 or 17, I was shooting weddings, bar mitzvahs, and portraits on a regular basis. I had my own tuxedo. So I've always had a lifelong interest in photography. But, you know, as your kids come along and you buy houses and sort of have a life, I started to go away from the professional stuff. And it's only in recent years that I have revived my nascent interest in photography and taken it much more seriously. The advent of digital photography has made photography a new kind of hobby. It's really allowed the everyman to become an artist. And I really think of photography as art, not just capturing images. Many people think of photography as taking an image of you today, right now. And I think that's true. But I see that as the first step. For me, I'm taking a picture of you and then seeing how I see you. Much like a painter interprets the world, I try and interpret the world through my photograph and then the post-processing that I do on it. I'm often asked what kind of equipment I use in my photography, and I think it's really important to recognize that the best camera is the one that you have with you. You know, if you don't have a camera with you, you're not going to do photography, so I always travel with a camera. There's always one in my briefcase, there's one in my office, so that I have a camera around to capture a moment, because moments disappear, they're ethereal, and if you can capture a specific moment, it's exciting. I'm a Nikon fan. I have a Nikon D800 and a whole gang of lenses that go with it. I also have a little Sony full-frame RX1 for those of you who are aficionados. But I really don't think it matters what kind of camera you use. You can produce stunning photography using an iPhone. Admittedly, with wonderful equipment, you can do more. But the real art is about capturing an image, seeing the world in a way that others don't see it, and capturing that moment. Because the moment it clicks, it's gone forever. And that's what it's about. It's not about the equipment. I think photography is a wonderful hobby, pastime, retirement activity, because you can do it anywhere at any time. And I think getting young people involved in capturing the world is a great thing to do. There are classes that are offered at universities, like Kent State. There are classes that are offered at YMCAs, through churches. There are all kinds of photography classes online that are free. You can go on the World Wide Web and listen to dozens of people speak about photography as an art form, as a craft. And I encourage people to do it because I think it's a great and relatively simple way to become an artist. There are lots of ways to become an artist. Some people paint, some sculpt, some photograph. And I think it's a great way to express creativity and to expand one's boundaries. The world is so beautiful. There are so many fabulous things that I think people just sort of sail through life and don't see the world. They don't capture the imagery of a flower. They don't see the sky. They don't see the stunningness of wonderful architecture. They don't recognize when they're in Florence or whether they're in London that many of these buildings have been there for hundreds of years. They've been appreciated by thousands or millions of people. And I think it's important to capture those moments the way I see them. Not only to remember them, but to let people reflect upon them. Some of the photographs that you see here today try and evoke an imagery that speaks not to a specific place, but to many places that you've seen. I have pictures of boats and sunsets that could happen in many different places. Now, if you've been to Provincetown or if you've been to Halifax, you recognize those individual places. But I think when you look at some of the images, you go, I've been there. Even though you might not have been just there, but it evokes a feeling. A photograph that doesn't evoke a feeling doesn't capture what I want it to capture. It should be personal. It should be like, wow, I like that. It means something to me. Much like a piece of music. Why is it that we like Monet? We like Monet because he captures a sense of awe and wonder of nature. I shoot people, I shoot photographs, I shoot architecture. I don't have a particular genre, but in every case, my best photography captures a moment in a special way. I have a picture of the Malaga Inn, which captures a southern feel that when you look at that photograph, you go, oh, that's the South. I have a photograph here today of California Street in San Francisco. And anyone who's been to San Francisco looks at that photograph and goes, oh, that's San Francisco. You just know it. And so I think that's part of what I'm trying to do. Capture a feeling, make it relate personally, and try and get away from the photograph as just capturing a moment in time, but a photograph that interprets the world. All of the photography that I have been doing the last few years while I've been at Kent State is for sale on my website. You can buy it here in this gallery, or you can go to my website and purchase it. And all of the proceeds from those sales, the net proceeds, are going to a Kent State scholarship that my wife and I have set up for students to study abroad. So all of these proceeds, I don't get any of the money, I don't make anything, I'm not doing it to make money. This is fun. It's creativity, it's art. People like it. People are purchasing thousands of dollars worth of it, and it's all going to Kent State students at the end of the day. It's going into an endowment. It's going to last forever because endowed funds last forever. So I encourage people to buy the photography because they not only get a piece of art for their home or office, but they also further endow a scholarship for Kent State students. It's www.lesterlefton.com, one big word, lesterlefton.com. Post-processing is the technique of using Photoshop or other kinds of software in the computer to take a digital image and enhance it, transmogrify it, give it a new look and feel, to really reflect what you thought you saw at that moment, not necessarily what the camera captured. Many people have asked me, am I going to become a full-time photographer when I retire? I fully expect that I will continue to do photography, probably have a little bit more time to do it when I'm not fully engaged as president. You know, the presidency job is really a seven days a week, pretty much all day long, every day, doing one thing or another. So I will continue my photography. It won't be a full-time passion, but I will be able to do it perhaps at a more leisurely pace. I'll always be posting that stuff on the web at www.lesterlefton.com.